got the stream up and going.
So you watched that speedrun, right?
No, I didn't watch that speedrun that you linked.
You should have. That means you have actually used the frickin' shield break.
Well, you know, I didn't really want spoilers. If you know what I'm
saying. That's not spoilers. You're never going to figure it out.
Okay. Anyway, let's just go ahead and get started here. Anyway, okay, guys, this is Michael Taharo. And it's a special Thursday morning edition of the stream. Usually I stream Wednesday nights around 9 Eastern, 8 Central. But, you know, I feel like playing Freedom Plant some more, getting into it again. Anyway, of course I'm joined by Barch!
Hey, hiya!
Anyway, you ready? Let's do this.
Absolutely.
Playing as Mila.
Wow! We're really strong as a team!
Anyway, you can go ahead and talk over these cutscenes, and Micklefire is in the chat.
Hello,
Micklefire.
So, Mike, did you see that Brawlhalla had a new update?
You linked to it. I didn't see it, really, though.
So, they're beginning Season 2, so you're ranked... Your rank has been reset, and they added in some end-of-season rewards, actually.
But with my playing, I didn't get anything.
All depending. How much did you play ranked? How many wins did you get?
I never played rank.
Oh, then yeah, you probably didn't get anything. As for myself, I got a sweet little skin color for Val.
Oh. You really like Val, don't you?
Oh, I love Val. Amazing character. Over there. To everybody in chat, I offer a hearty invitation to play Brawlhalla because it is amazing. Very good. Wonderful little indie game.
Who disposed of this wretched mechanical beast?
You bet we are.
Glorious! As a token of my appreciation, I offer each of you free reign over.
Anyway, I don't think any of this is gonna be new material to watch, so I'm gonna skip this scene.
Mm-hmm. Just remember, like the new material happens once they actually separate.
Mm-hmm.
So when they're all together like this, you're not gonna get new stuff.
Alright, well, might as well just go to the next stage then. Screw it! Let's do it! And I just ran right into a bomb.
Good job.
God, I am so smart. Okay.
So the achievement for this stage, I believe, is actually completing it without using Torque's plane.
Well,
which I actually don't know how to do, so that's fun. But it's very fun to know that you can. Maybe you just have to go like backwards and like go like the long way around instead of actually using Torque's plane as like a shortcut.
Oh, so I think so basically go backwards you came.
Yeah, but that's only a guess. I might be completely and totally wrong.
Seems rather silly, but okay.
I mean, like, most achievements are silly, to be fair. And when they're not, they're doing it wrong.
Oh my gosh.
Do you ever play Half-Life 2 by chance?
No.
That is unfortunate, because I was about to talk about one of my favorite achievements from that game.
Is the video choppy on your end?
Yep, a little bit of choppiness. Probably just a hiccup. Don't worry about it.
That's gonna bother me.
I keep on telling you, Mike, all you can do is wait it out.
Yeah. Still bothers me. It also bothers me that after getting those health pickups, I'm down to no health now. I'm such a moron. Yay for me.
Mila's just a little softy. She can only take so much punishment.
Yes.
Stream's back up to 100% now. At least for me. Mikafire asks, is it the gnome achievement for Half-Life 2? No, not the one I was thinking of. The one that I had the most fun doing was actually this achievement where you have to go through Ravenholm using only the gravity gun, which is an incredibly fun idea just because, like, I always like achievements and challenges where it's like, you have to use only your base equipment. Like, stuff like, let's say, like, Legend of Zelda 3 heart runs. Like, those are kind of amazing. In first Legend of Zelda, in NES Legend of Zelda, there's actually an achievement, well, not an achievement, but there's this challenge that the internet came up with where you can go through the entire game without picking up the sword and only using items. That's amazing. That's an amazing idea. Like, I love shit like that. Red Mage Mike's friend visited Valve the other day. They don't have a third floor. I'm like, I'm happy about that. I never really was a big fan of really, really tall buildings. Like, I can deal okay with, like, a second floor, but I'm definitely not
too
big a
fan. You, like, have agoraphobia or something?
Is that the fear of heights, I assume?
Yeah?
Little bit. I mean, like... Like, for example, I was at Phoenix Comic Con, and, like, I did not like going up and down those escalators, because those were, like, four-story tall escalators. Hmm. And once I was away from, like, edges, I'm okay. Like, even though, like, I'm still as high, but, like, I don't have to look down. But I probably got a little bit of agoraphobia, yeah.
Well, that was a terrible... Boo-hoo.
Acrophobia. Whatevs. Fear of Heights is so much easier to say than just scientific name. Mm-hmm. That goes for most phobias.
Yeah. And I'm dying a lot in this level.
Keep on running into the friggin' lasers. Just fly over, you got ears, you big dummy. Use them.
Well, I tried and I ran to a friggin' laser.
Plus, you're making a mistake of trying to destroy them, really. Like, you should just fly on by them.
It'd
be very cool to visit Valve. Let's get it like a studio tour sometime. Especially if you were somebody important, so they actually like go above and beyond in the studio tour. Like a fellow game developer or something, you know, like Kojima, you know. If Kojima like visits Valve, they're going to be like, "Oh god, got to make this good."
Why am I doing this the hard way? I kept doing this the hard way. I should have done it the easy way. I am such
a moron.
What was
the easy way?
Anyway, just forming the block and just throwing it up. Jumping and throwing it, jumping and throwing it. Instead of using the little shield breaker move. Like
absolutely.
I had been doing.
The one thing is that I think that just using the block on its own is slightly less damage. That's the one thing that you gotta keep in mind, so it's a little bit of a trade-off.
Come on.
See the vault where Half-Life 3 is hidden? It's under lock and key. It's always kind of interesting, because a lot of people are feeling sore nowadays about Valve as a games company, because Valve has been so busy with the hardware side of things. That...
Like the SteamOS?
Yeah, SteamOS, Steam Machines, the Steam Controller, the Vive. Like, they have been so busy with the hardware side of things that they have never... They haven't put out a video game since Portal 2, I believe. And a lot of people are feeling sore about that, because they do want some new games from this company that they love. But at the same time, I think that those hardware things are amazing enough that I'm happy that Valve is doing it, in a way, you know? Like, I mean, like, they're pushing the boundary with stuff like the Steam Controller and the Vive. Like, those are revolutionary for games. So I think what people have to understand is that, like, even if, like, Valve isn't coming out with new games, they're pushing gaming in a way that other companies really aren't right now. And that kind of innovation, I think, is important, for sure.
Oh, shit.
Oh. Even if I do want Half-Life 3 and I want Portal 3. Portal 3 will be interesting because the soundtrack will obviously contain, like, 6 different CDs. The first one had almost no music, and then the second one had 3 CDs worth of music.
Maybe we'll
so they
hear
can only
it...
go up.
Maybe What's we'll up? Hear an electronic mix of Doug Ratman's rant.
Maybe.
Yeah. It's like... Shh.
Portal 2 had an excellent soundtrack, by the way, especially if you like electronic music and you like, you know, just generally, like, hard-hitting electronic beats. Like, there was some really, really good stuff in there, especially the Faithplate soundtrack song that plays whenever you hit a Faithplate in that game. That game was kind of amazing. I always kind of praise it just because they had so much contextual music. Like, hitting a Faithplate, hitting Goop, everything had a song to it. Even just the light bridges and the sound that they emitted, they made that a full song on the soundtrack. And it was this really, like, ambient kind of track that I really loved. There was a lot of care and love put into the Portal 2 soundtrack.
Yes.
Would you ever play a first-person game, Maiku, or would it actually give you the vertigo?
I would be in very short bursts if I do play, because I have been in the middle of playing Portal Stories Mel, and I haven't really gotten that far to meet the person or who is imitating Cave Johnson.
Right.
Or Virgil.
Right.
So...
I actually was playing that one myself, and I stopped playing because I didn't quite enjoy the puzzle design as much as I hoped I would. And plus, it was a whole lot, like, weirdly difficult. Like, it's the kind of difficulty that happens just because you're an amateur game designer. Like, not having, like, a steady difficulty curve, but more like just random spikes along the way. So I never actually did complete Portal Story Mel. What was it called?
Portal
Maiku?
Stories Mel.
Portal Stories Mel. That's a hard name to remember. But yeah, Portal stories I never completed, and I probably never will complete, because I've got better things. Pipeline. I do appreciate the effort that was put in, though, especially at the beginning. There was a lot of cinematicness that was kind of enjoyable. But as it goes on, it gets harder and harder in a way that I really didn't expect.
Make a fire! Game over, it is Mila!
Yeah, death counter for you, Maiku. That'd be fun. Take a drink every time Maiku dies. You are now dead.
Now if we did that, we would have a bunch of alcoholics watching our stream. Yes, it is your folly.
Folly of Miko. Folly of your words.
God damn it. Could you? I do not like this helicopter.
So I've been liking asking this question lately. And feel free to answer yourselves, chat, but is anybody looking forward to any games, any movies that are coming out anytime soon? I always like to know what people are looking forward to, because myself, I look forward to a lot of things.
Well, there's
not so much on the movie side.
Well, there's a new Pac-Man game that just came out that I want to get.
Not something that's already out, but stuff that's coming out. Although that...
Well, you know what I'm looking forward to. Then how you rib me on it every single time I bring it up.
Which is?
I'm not going to say it.
I don't know what it is though.
I'm not gonna give you the satisfaction.
Okay. The new Pokemon. I mean, I'm happy for you, but at the same time,
I do not have a high opinion of Pokemon.
Like. So the sad thing for me is that I love what the artists do with Pokemon, but I just hate the game. Just the general game design is just awful. Like, they have done nothing with that game series over its lifespan. But the art is good, the Pokemon are good, I love, like, the new designs, the game itself sucks, you know? It's just one of those things where you love, like, the graphics, but the game itself is awful. Kind of like Ori and the Blind Forest was for me. What else is in that? What else was... terrible game, but with amazing graphics? Metal Gear Solid 5 Ground Zeroes, I suppose. I tried playing that, and that was not an enjoyable experience. Persona 5, I've seen a lot of people very, very excited for Persona. It's kind of funny,
what
because I didn't...
What happened? Okay. Been trying so hard to defeat that chopper, and finally, you know, it takes two hits. I mean, did the game just go into easy mode on me or something?
Maybe.
Yeah.
Or there was a glitch. It looks like it just went off screen, funnily enough.
Mm-hmm. Want me an extra life?
So, Mickafire asked me about playing Phantom Pain. The thing is that I played Ground Zeroes, and, like, I have been trying to get into Metal Gear Solid as, like, a franchise, because it's got a lot of fans, and it's got a lot of people that like it.
But, every
single game that I have ever played in Metal Gear Solid, I didn't. And I have tried. I have tried so hard to get into that franchise. I played the first one on the PS1, and I was bored by that. I played the third one on PS2, and that... controls were awful. They felt so stiff and freaking... Oh. And Ground Zeroes, I did not like the level design of, because I could never, like, tell who was coming from where, and that was very annoying.
Of course, Mickafire is talking about Phantom Pain. Not
I know,
Phantom
but we might as well just talk about it as Phantom Pain. Ignore the joke entirely.
Yes.
And yeah, just because I'm having, like, such a hard time to enjoy, like, Metal Gear Solid as a franchise. Oh, and I tried playing the fourth one and I got bored and, like, irritated there as well. Although I think I have the highest opinion of the fourth one, funnily enough. Because at least the controls were good. But... but yeah, because of all of those troubles that I've had with the games, I'm just probably not going to buy Phantom Pain because it's expensive. And I'm finding that I, even though I'm trying so hard, I just don't like the franchise. But yeah, back to Persona 5, I've been seeing a lot about it. I've been seeing a lot of people loving on the UI of the game. The UI of Persona 5 has a lot of work done on it. Very flashy and very unique for what it does. I'm not sure if I would like the game or not. I mean, like, the thing about Persona is that it's an RPG, and I'm learning that I really don't like a lot of RPG mechanics that everybody else expects and loves. As for me, I pre-purchased a Cluster Truck, and I'm looking forward to that coming out.
You played the demo.
I played the demo. Not even the demo, just like an early build of it, which means that the game is going to be even better. Probably going to stream that. Of course, Owlboy has finally received a release date, and it's happening very, very soon. And I'm very, very excited for that one. That is a game that is a long time coming. Very hotly anticipated for me. Like, that is a game that is probably going to be an instant classic once it comes out. Like, people don't know it yet, but that game is going to be, like, the next Undertale. Like, just mark my words, okay? It is going to sell like hotcakes, and all of your friends are going to be talking about it. Even though nobody knows it right now.
Oh, gosh, I almost went off the ship!
Good job. Oh god, I just saw it on my screen. That was amazing. Amazing save, Maiku. What a save!
No! I've fallen!
Mickafire talking about Nier Automata in the chat. Nier's another RPG, so I haven't really looked into it too much, but I know that there was a... You know, the funny thing is about the previous Nier game, that all I know about it is I saw a review that Yahtzee did. And of course, he did his whole spiel about ranting about the game. So... I think that he liked it anyway. But then again, there aren't too many things that Yahtzee does like. Yeah, Owlboy Mikafire. Let me go ahead and give you the trailer, maybe, if you haven't already looked it up yourself. The music is wonderful, the game design is wonderful, the graphics are amazing. Like some of the best pixel art I've seen in a while, so. Owlboy is definitely going to be like a day one purchase for me, hopefully. I had in time, got delayed until the beginning of next year, which I'm kind of sad about. But I am fine waiting for that game because it's just that amazing. That's going to be another one that is going to take, like, everybody by storm. And I'm looking forward to Rain World. Although I don't know if that one has received a release date yet or not. Problems in it. Problems, Maiku.
Yes, there are
it's
problems.
It's just like you wave your arms in such a dismissive way on screen. Let me see if I watch you. Maybe I can help you out, give you a little bit of a tip here and there. So this fight actually should be pretty easy with Mila. I'm so jealous of you sometimes, Mikafire, because you're able to back a lot of games that I wished I could back. And I wish I could have my name in the credits just to be able to say, I knew this was going to be amazing. Fuck all of you. Oh yeah, I almost forgot, Creepy Castle. Oh my god, Creepy Castle is coming out. That is going to be my Halloween game. It is coming out on Halloween. It is gonna be good. That's the only game that I've been able to back on Kickstarter. Because I actually had money when it was in its funding level. And it's funny because I've been ranting about RPGs this entire time, but Creepy Castle is an RPG, but at the same time, I think it's that flavor of RPG that I actually like where it actually does something new. Instead of just saying, hey, press A a bunch. Mikafire as well had a lot of disposable income at that time.
Yeah, I hear you, Mikafire. I no longer have that kind of luxury.
Same. Because there's a lot of Kickstarters that I wish I could back. There's so many things that I would have loved to have funded a little bit.
Golly.
Exploding kittens.
Let's
see. Oh boy, actually, what star was it? No, it wasn't. Undertale, actually. Undertale is always kind of funny to look at because it went completely insane once it was actually released, but on Kickstarter it received like a minimum amount of funding. Like it barely scraped by at the idea stage. And then it became this like national sensation upon release.
This giant juggernaut of indie games.
Yeah.
Basically.
Absolutely. Very well put. Curious about Lady Layden. Lady Layden was just announced, and I'm happy for that one, for sure. Kind of, anyway. Is it only... You know what? Let me look it up. Because is that on the only platform that I fucking hate right now? Almost. Oh, okay. So Lady Layden will actually be released on Nintendo 3DS, Android, and iOS. Which means that I will actually have that on a platform that I at least kind of like. Because I do have an Android phone. And now you're not allowed to like Undertale because it's too popular. Honestly, fuck the haters.
God damn it all to hell. The frickin' Prince Dale blew me back so far and knocked me off the ship.
I honestly hate, like, the, that mentality of people who just hate things because they're popular and not, like, judging them on their own basis. Like, people just let, like, the fandom and just the popularity of Undertale color their opinion of it. And that's so dumb to me. Like, I hate a lot of things, but let me tell you, I have my own reasons for hating them. Based on the mechanics in the game itself, instead of just hating it for, like, extraneous things that the game can't control. I hate it for things the game can control, like the game mechanics.
Oh, you're not blowing me off again, you're not blowing me off again, you're not blowing me off again.
What, do you have a date with Prince Dale, Maiku?
Oh, yeah, I'm
and
having
he's been blowing you off?
Let's not go there!
I think your mind went in the gutter there, not mine. I was just talking about blowing you off for a date. That's a perfectly normal and acceptable phrase, Maiku. How dare you? How dare you?
You're doing that on purpose.
I have no idea what you're talking about. On the movie side of things, I'm actually not looking forward to anything. Like, I have found out recently that I'm a big animation buff, and all of the animation movies that are coming out are fucking awful. Except for Mona, I guess. I am looking forward to Mona. Mona looks really, really good. But you don't even need me to tell you about that. Everybody is gonna go see Mona once it comes out in Thanksgiving.
I won't.
Really?
Really.
For why?
I just don't go to movies.
Fair enough.
I would like to actually be able to go with somebody to the movies, but I'm single! Nobody wants to go out with me! I'm 35, I'm bald, I work at a gas station.
Oh, Mike, you totally go with the movies with you if I was there, damn it. So I take it that means that you actually didn't see Kubo and the Two Strings then?
Nope.
Damn. If you get to catch that one on like pay-per-view or Netflix or whatever, whenever it comes out, highly recommend checking that one out. Because that was a really, really good movie that I loved quite a bit, and I'm quite sad that it didn't do that well at the box office. Oh, Red Mage Mike shares my feelings, by the way, about, like, current animation movies that are coming out. Sing looks awful. Like, kind of. So the thing about Sing is that I fucking hate, like, every single piece of humor that's in the movie. But I like the gorilla's backstory that's in there. Because it's actually kind of a sweet little backstory. But it's surrounded in this movie that markets itself in, like, the worst way possible. Every single joke, every single soundtrack bit, I hate it so much. Let me see, there's a bunch of movies that are coming out there that look awful in the same way. There's also Storks, I suppose. There was Norm of the North. Secret Life of Pets. Like, people have decided that animation needs to be more annoying than anything else in order to sell, and I hate it so much. But I still have hope, because there do exist still, like, amazing animated movies. Like the one that came out this year, at the beginning of the year, with Kung Fu Panda 3.
Kung Fu Panda 3, are you kidding me right now?
Okay, so the name, like, I know the name sounds silly as all get out, and it sounds awful almost from the name alone, but I assure you, Kung Fu Panda as a series is actually really amazing. Like, it is actually one of my favorite recent, like, movie franchises.
Well, I did see the first movie.
First one was amazing. Like, yes. An instant classic.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't feel that it's gotten to that point where it's, like, wearing itself out. Like, maybe once it passes, like, the trilogy point, it'll be pretty bad. But right now, I quite like it. Like Shrek. Once Shrek passed, like, the trilogy standpoint, I think people started to really, really get tired. Like, I think you can say that for a lot of movies, honestly. Like, you can get away with a trilogy, but after that, a lot of people will start getting tired. Which is probably why, like, Star Wars has marketed itself in trilogies. You should definitely go Wired sometime, Red Mage Mike. It's a whole lot better. Not perfect, though. Even I get hiccups sometimes, even on a wired connection. But it's a whole lot better than Wi-Fi, that's for sure. For every single, like, online game that is, like, out there, I guarantee you that one of the developers has, like, a blog talking about how bad it is to play their game on Wi-Fi. Like, League of Legends, you can see, like, one of the developers talking about, like, testing out things on Wi-Fi, and it just being an awful experience for the player. Brawlhalla specifically has a help guide for, you know, fixing your connection, and, like, the number one thing they say is switch to a wired connection.
No!
Oh, you're at work. Fair enough, Red Mage Mike. Come on, Maiku. I believe in you. You can do it!
You can do it! How could it hit me? Oh my god!
You were just barely standing in the way of it. Like, the lines aren't exact. Like, they go kind of, like, outside of it. So you gotta really make sure you're in a safe spot. That's true, Mikafire, I did speak. I still believe in Maiku, though. He's immortal, after all. Even an immortal being can overcome the worst of foes.
Yeah. We're not talking about real life events, are we?
What, you think I'm immortal? How silly. Where would you ever come up with the very idea? Oh, if I may advertise on your stream for a second here, my coup.
Alright.
I am selling a lot of things nowadays, so if anybody wants anything that I am selling, then hit me up, because especially I'm trying to get rid of my Nintendo 3DS right now. An original Nintendo 3DS. Let me see, what else am I selling? I'm selling a mechanical keyboard. What else? I'm selling a fight stick, but I know nobody will be interested in that. Small crowd, so I probably won't get any bites, but if you are interested, then go ahead and hit me up on my Twitter. That guy Borch. For a second, Mikafire thought I was selling drugs.
What? What?
Just because of the intro. Hey, you want to buy something, kid? What are you selling? What are you buying? You will face justice. Surrender. I can't. I won't. So you have chosen
death. How pathetic. Prince Dale is just a piece of garbage!
Learn the movements, Maiku. Learn the movements. Let me see, what else am I selling? Let me look at my Craigslist for a second. There's that shit ton of stuff that I'm selling. Still kinda trying to sell my PS3. And my Wii. And I would sell my Wii U if it hadn't decided to fucking brick itself. I still gotta take a look at that. Maybe send it to Nintendo or some shit. Such nonsense.
Boy. You know, it's funny that I managed to beat 3 levels yesterday, and today, I'm barely managing to beat this one.
To be fair, this is the boss that is actually, the first boss that is actually difficult. But at the same time, you do just kind of gotta really, really get used to the patterns. And get used to being in safe spots when you need to be. Getting pretty good about the shield breaker, though. And breaking the ostrich. You're still going in the way of it, though. Like, all you gotta do is do a simple jump when the ostrich is swooping.
Thing is, that is a peacock.
Ostrich, peacock, same diff.
It's
difficulty curve, kind of. I mean, like, this is the first actually difficult boss, but it's still not that difficult. I feel like this game does have a really, really good difficulty curve. It's just that it has actually, like, the bosses take actual effort, you know? And, like, so many games that are like this, so many platformers just have bosses that are all flash, but, like, no substance. Whereas with Freedom Planet, you really can't screw around with bosses. Like, you have to take them seriously. Like, I've talked about this every now and then, but I love Sonic.
No. Almost fell.
I love Sonic to bits, but it has horrible bosses. The actual levels are what is enjoyable, but bosses are awful. You're almost there, Maiku.
Almost, but not quite. Okay, see, Mikafire's getting in on the joke, misnaming the bird. And finally.
Good job. We're proud of you.
This is far from over.
Did Mila just call herself a super dog?
I can believe it. Super dog! Mila, the super dog! Saving the day. One pest at a time.
God damn it, Mikafire. The joke is getting old.
The joke has only just begun. Huh.
So that's why your airships are boat-shaped.
Things have been pretty crazy so far, huh?
Yeah.
How long have you been away from your parents?
I'm not sure. It feels like a really long time.
And you've been alone in the woods ever since?
Yeah.
I hope this doesn't sound weird, but that's kind of impressive. I wouldn't survive a day without my treehouse. Hey, when this is all over, how about we have a girls' night out? Just you and me.
You mean a play date?
Something like that. We could try out some dresses, or maybe buy a huge plate of sushi and just pig out.
I would like to pig out.
What about Carol? Can she come too?
Good luck getting her to put a dress on.
Well, sure. I'd like that.
Great.
Look, everyone! The city!
Friends, how did the negotiations fare?
Oh, and in terms of games to look forward to, I just found out that there's a couple of, Ghouls and Ghosts tributes actually coming to Steam. And I'm really excited for that. One of them was a freeware game, Maldita Castile. It's my understanding that and that was actually on Greenlight, so... Not exactly. And they're porting that to Steam, and they're adding some new features to it. And I'm pretty excited for that, because I love Ghouls and Ghosts as a franchise. I'm really excited for people who are inspired for it to be making games. And you have proof of this. This is a fragment of one of Brevin's... And if we ever wanted to piss off Maiku here, we should have him play Super Ghouls and Ghosts sometime.
Don't. Have your scientists
examine it. Yes.
No.
I could barely
unless you
back.
Want to you want to hear a string of expletives coming out of my mouth. No.
That could be fun. Wait, don't touch it. What do you think, Shaq? Could that be fun? I think that could be fun. This theory you have of a man from another world sounds. If you will allow me to explain, Magister, I have a proceed. This is nothing but an attempt from Mayor Zhao to cover up the atrocity he must have offered you a generous after all. You can't resist. That's very unfortunate that you think that, Mikafire. I like the voice acting in this game, but it's something that a lot of people disagree with me on. have the two of you been saying that it's in general amateurish.
The same group that claimed responsibility for the red scarves.
Hey, look, Lilac, it's our identical twin sisters.
They're criminals and spies, Your Excellency.
Is this true?
Beat the first level in a bit under a week, maybe.
We're no longer members of the Scarves.
Yes, remember my daily morning Undertale uploads trying to beat Sans, and well, it's a good thing Ziggurox isn't here, I can say that.
Detain them until further notice. Make sure the commander and his evidence are properly quarantined.
Super Ghouls and Ghosts, like, the way I found out about it was that the Game Grumps actually took a look at it, and they could not actually get past the first level. Like, they stopped after three episodes.
Examine the fragment! Examine it!
So they must have spent about, I don't know, half an hour to an hour on the first level, and they couldn't beat it. And that was hilarious to me, so I decided to give that a run. And that actually turned out to be one of my favorite games. Oh, I should totally put it on my favorite games list. Kind of. The only thing about Super Ghouls and Ghosts is that it has a very unfortunate end peak. Like, the second to last boss and the last boss are not enjoyable to fight. But the rest of the game is quite wonderful.
The sooner you find Torque, the sooner we can get out of here.
There's lots of things that the game did that I really, really respected at the time, considering that it came out on the Super Nintendo. I wish that they would re-release it, honestly. Like, Capcom just stopped putting out games for it. Like, Ghouls and Ghosts is this franchise that is actually Capcom-owned, and they just completely stopped, like, doing stuff for it. Like, the last game that they came out for it was on the PSP.
Okay, here's some... Well, this is Sanu.
What are you gonna do to me?
Relax. It's dishonorable to hurt small children. Follow me.
Yeah, true. Red Mage Mike is talking about Capcom has dropped a lot of things that they were working on as of late.
Sorry.
To fans' chagrin.
Tell the Magister, I want to confess.
What?
Very well.
I was wondering if Capcom just doesn't like money.
It's okay. I have
like, there's a lot of things that they aren't doing that I think that they should do. Like, they should have done, like, Mega Man Legends 3, because there's so many people who are asking for it. We should get Steam releases of the Mega Man games. Because it is incredible how many Mega Man games there are, and that almost none of them are on Steam.
A bonus dialogue coming up.
Huh?
We shall establish a Tim Tam's currency exchange program.
No, it's okay. I was just surprised is all. Go ahead.
Since you have displayed...
Anyway, you were saying?
...revealing this farce, I will release your friend. But this does not change your...
McFire says, Capcom will happily reference all of their beloved franchises, but God forbid they actually do anything with them.
And in doing so have wasted our time and resources. You will remain...
Mega Man is definitely like that. Like, I wonder what the sales figures were for the last couple of Mega Man games. Because, I mean, like, if they were bad, then I could understand, I suppose. At least a little bit. Like, I thought that Mega Man 9 and 10 actually sold really well. So I would expect that they would have kept on making Mega Man games.
I know, but we can't do anything while we're all sitting behind bars.
But what about you guys?
We'll catch up with you. Busting out of here will be a piece of crab cake.
All right, now we're in Jade Creek. Let's get started.
Mega Man 9 sold 110,000 digital copies.
Yeah, I bought one of them.
Capcom was very happy about Mega Man 9 sales. As also stated, they were pleased with Mega Man 10 sales.
Want that
too. So then it begs the question, why did they just stop? It's so interesting to me. Like, I want more Mega Man games, and I want more Ghouls and Ghosts games. I suppose if I did want my Mega Man fix, though, there's a billion fan games that I could take a spin through. Even a Capcom-published one, with Mega Man X Street Fighter.
Can get better than this robot frog.
Oh yeah, I can completely and totally understand that. My friend is pissed off at Konami because they bought the Bomberman IP and refused to do anything with it. Konami is holding, like, a bunch of IPs hostage. Like, one that I particularly love that they've never done anything with was Rocket Knight. Because they released one game multi-platform that was kind of a reimagining of Rocket Knight, and then did nothing else with it. Let's see, how many IPs does Konami hold under its shit, under its roof? Because
under its shit?
And like, obviously there's Castlevania, which they have badly piloted, in my opinion. Silent Hill? Oh my god, Silent Hill is under Konami. Like, they have so many good games that they don't deserve to be in their grasp. Contra? I suppose. I was never too big a fan of Contra, so I'm not too sad about not seeing any more games for it. And I mean, like, anybody could do a Contra game, let's be honest.
I'm sorry, I'm just concentrating.
Absolutely. I'm actually surprised that you're still going. I would have expected you to have stopped after you beat, like, Dale and being stuck on him for a while.
Well, an hour hasn't passed yet.
But fair enough.
I'll be stopping after I defeat Neera. Or is it Neela? Need Nayla. Something.
Nayla. Of course, Metal Gear Solid is under Konami.
I've got invincibility and you don't, so I have to defeat you. But you're going away too fast, so come here so that I can kick your ass, please. Okay, I need to stop.
Konami holds Bomberman, Gradius, Lost in Blue, Yu-Gi-Oh! Oh my god, they hold the Yu-Gi-Oh! License. Oh, that is awful for fans of that card game. Dance Dance Revolution. God.
Okay, to answer your question, Mikafire, I do have everybody's vocals put out in the project. I am working on it. I was waiting on somebody else to send me their vocals, but that individual has not done so. So I'm going to start working on it a bit more tonight, possibly. Either that or just listen to Doctor Who audio stories.
Just procrastinate the day away, right, Michael?
Yeah, well, the thing is, I've had these audio files on my folder for like 5 years, and I haven't listened to them all yet.
That's totally fair. Oh, I'll have to take a picture of my sister's birthday cake. Because she's having a birthday within the next couple days, I believe.
Oh, wow.
And the birthday cake that my parents actually decided to get her was an Okami cake.
Oh, wow. Because, yeah, my baby sister's birthday is this Sunday, so...
What a coinkydink.
God damn it, Nero. Stop being a jerk. Let me beat you! God damn it!
I was kind of impressed that my parents were willing to go with a video game cake. Very accepting of them. Instead of just going with, like, their own taste.
Really, Mickafire?
Dinka 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 dinka.
Damn it. Yeah. My birthday is next month.
Nice.
God damn it, Nira. You're really getting me.
Nayla is probably the one that I had the hardest time on. Like, I can do her fairly easily now, but my first playthrough, I think I was stuck on her for quite a bit. Especially since I faced her with, Carol. And I think Carol has, like, the hardest, like, moveset for Nayla. Because Carol has no way to actually, Oh, I think it was because I hadn't learned, like, Carol's, like, invincibility frames. That was probably why I was having a hard time. Because obviously if you don't learn Carol's invincibility frames by the time you hit Nayla, you're going to have a hard time. Because she has all kinds of ways to hit you.
Yeah. And she is handing my ass to me repeatedly.
Off you go, Mila, to jail.
Throw your hands in the air, and wave them like you just don't care, ya.
Where did that come from?
You'll see in a moment.
Oh. It's hilarious.
God damn it, stay in one place!
Oh, I can't wait to have my sister's cake. I just thought about that, the fact that I'm having cake soon.
Oh, you're just drooling over that right now, aren't you?
Oh, yeah. Especially since me and my sister have similar tastes and we both like chocolate cake.
Oh. Yeah, I like carrot cake with cream cheese frosting.
Ew.
I used to enjoy chocolate cake, but carrot cake's pretty awesome.
Not my thing, but I'm happy for you.
Of course, there's one cake that trumps them all, and that, of course, is cheesecake. Damn.
Hot dog cupcakes. That's kind of cute.
What?
Keep in mind, I think it's probably just in the shape of a hot dog and not actually a hot dog.
Better not be. That'd be stupid.
Although I would wonder what the shape was like. What were they like? Like, how were they packaged?
I hope you use crescent rolls.
like Pillsbury crescent rolls that come in that tube.
Oh, that would be Frank's in a blanket. That's what you're thinking of, thank you. I make some mean Frank's in a blanket, let me say. Even though everything I make is like prepackaged, so it's just Pillsbury crescent rolls with like store-bought hot dogs, but you know, still tastes amazing. Oh no, Red Magic Mike says, as in cupcakes made with hot dogs. They were gross. Oh my god, okay.
What? Why? Why on earth would you do that?
Well, you gotta understand, Maiku, is some people are just terrible at cooking. And they want to try, like, things that don't make any sense whatsoever. Like, carrots and cake.
Don't you knock off carrot cake! How dare you! You monster!
You could hear the needle drop in that silence before the storm. Regular cupcakes with chunks of hot dogs in them. Those are two flavors that I don't want to taste together. He does this a lot, apparently. I would just stop eating their food. But you're wasting food! That's not food, okay? It's not wasting if it's not food.
Yeah, rhubarb pie is a thing. Mincemeat pie is also a thing.
I never liked anything that has, like, pie in the name, but it has meat. Like, shepherd's pie, for example, is just... Oh my god. Ugh.
What about...
I get sick just thinking about it. What about what, Maiku?
I've misunderstood what you were saying.
Fair enough. Mincemeat pie? I don't know. Let me see. What is that? Let me look that up real quick. No, that looks about what I would dislike as well. And probably a big reason why I hate shepherd's pie is because I hate mashed potatoes. Mashed potatoes are awful. Just like pie in general, but chocolate pie.
Banana cream pie. Peach pie. Lemon meringue pie. Key lime pie.
Red Mage Mike feels me. He hates my mashed potatoes as well. Mashed potatoes just have like this texture to them that is just, ugh, like gummy and it gets everywhere and it's just, ugh, god. I can't even put into words why I dislike mashed potatoes. I just hate them.
Is it the texture?
Yeah, that's a lot of it. Even just the flavor, though. Everything about mashed potatoes is awful. Like, it's my number one hated food thus far, I think. And my parents are always like, how could you eat those? They're amazing. A kid that dislikes mashed potatoes. I cannot believe it. Because apparently, I guess, kids love mashed potatoes, whatever.
How do you feel about corn?
Don't like it. There's a lot of stuff at, like, a Thanksgiving spread that I just will not be able to eat. Like, my favorite part about Thanksgiving is the pastry. But turkey, I don't like. Ham, I don't like. Mashed potatoes, I don't like. There's a... Corn, I don't like. There's a lot of things in your average Thanksgiving spread that I will just not be able to eat.
What about dressing? Cranberry sauce?
Wouldn't that go into not liking turkey? Don't you have dressing with turkey? Like, eat it together. Isn't, like, the dressing inside of the turkey? I don't know.
I mean, in some places it is. Sometimes it's a separate dish. I do not like Neera.
Nayla. I think anyway. You know what? Let me double check. Freedom Planet characters. Carol Team, Mila Bassett. Thane, Royal Magister, General Gong, Mayor Zhao. Oh, you're right! It is Neera Lee. Okay, I'm an idiot. Sorry, Maiku, I've been correcting you this entire time and leading you down the path of darkness. It totally is Neera. Octavius Brevin. Carol T, voiced by Amanda Lott. I love Carol. I can't say it enough during these streams. I love Carol as a character. Excellent design, excellent color scheme, excellent voice actor, excellent cuteness. Just everything about Carol is awesome. Do you have a favorite yet, Maiku, actually?
Not really. I know.
Interesting. I mean, like, you really like a Royal Magister, though, don't you?
Well, I like his voice. That's about it. I just gotta get used to Mila's controls.
Absolutely. This is a pretty wild one, especially because there's not really any health packs to make it easier. Like, Neera kind of ambushes you in a way that all the other bosses don't. Like, you've got health packs with, like, a lot of the bosses.
I mean, even with the second fight with Dale, you get a health.
Yeah. Packs. I mean, like, you got millions of health packs since all the creatures drop them. You got a good rhythm going on, though. Just gotta hold it until you get the weak spot.
Yeah, my timing is just freaking...
Not up to par.
Up to par, yeah.
Edwin Teong is pretty damn good. Like, who'd he voice? Did he voice Torque? Because I actually follow him just as a voice actor. Oh, he voices the Royal Magister. Oh my god. So his username is Omadon, and like, I know about him from all of his VG Cats dubs that he did, where he would talk over the VG Cats comics. And that was just an amazing thing, and now he's this professional voice actor that is appearing in, like, all these video games. It's actually kind of funny to hear that he did the Royal Magister, because usually his voices are fairly, dorky and high-pitched. So he's got some range. It's enjoyable. After this one, we're gonna have to call it quits, by the way, Maiku.
Ah, damn it! I'm getting so frustrated right now!
Let it build. Keep on grabbing a box, though, when Mira is doing her ice attack, and that's a big problem. You gotta be able to fly. They are what, Mikifire? What are you asking?
Gotta let her attack first, then I can release the Y button.
Boo, Mikifire, boo. Who's last in three called and wants its jokes back? I hate anybody who, like, makes fun of Linkin Park, honestly. Kind of. I suppose I can understand making fun of the old songs. But then they don't care to learn about, like, the new good stuff that Linkin Park has been coming out with. Because that band, like, really grew over time. Oh hey, keep in mind that you actually don't even need to get the box to be able to block Nira's attacks. You could actually just use the normal shield. It's actually much faster too, since you don't have to summon it. Although, to be fair, that would make it to where it's harder to get the attack off after the fact. So yeah, maybe that's not the best advice.
Yeah. How many times have I gamed over? Has anybody been keeping track?
Well, I don't think anybody's been keeping track. I'm glad to hear that you think that way, Miko. It's nice to hear at least a little bit of, I don't know, encouragement about Linkin Park. So I really, really do love some of their most recent stuff. I gotta listen to it. It's been a while since I've listened to the albums that I have. I must rectify that.
Did you just say correctify?
Rectify.
It sounded like you said correctify for a second there.
I definitely said rectify.
It'd have been funny if you did say correctify, to be honest.
It would be in line with my normal, like, mispronouncing things.
Like booty traps?
Yes.
I still find that hilarious.
The funny part is that I've been finding that I get phrases wrong the most as of late, though. Like, what was the big one that Nate made fun of me for? The proof is in the pudding?
Yeah! That one! And damn it, I died.
Mikifire has been keeping track of how many times you died. says 7,530 times you have died.
That actually seems accurate.
Come on, Mikey, you're the most OP character in the game. You got this.
Finally.
I'm not sure if it was proof from the pudding that I exactly said, but it was probably a, it was something else. It was something, God, what was it? I wonder if I can even, like, look it up before we end the stream. Oh, actually, we're ending the stream now, aren't we? Damn it.
No, we still got to finish this level.
All right, I'll see if I can find it. Oh, that's what I said. I said the results are in the pudding.
Silly Borch.
I do that a lot, honestly. Or I'll just minorly, like, I'll forget, like, one part of how something is pronounced, or I'll forget one part of a phrase, and I'll fill in the blank. And obviously a lot of the things that I mispronounce, it's because I used to be a really big book reader, and I learned most of my words from reading books, and a book doesn't tell you how to pronounce things.
Good lord. All these explosions.
Jife is actually a part of that, because I'd always just read Jife, and then I learned that there was this big debate about how it's pronounced. And I was pronouncing it neither of the ways that people pronounced it. Because people pronounce it either Jif or Gif, but I say Jife.
Okay. Freedom Planet froze on me for a second there.
Oh, good. That's kind of interesting. I've always felt that this was a very solid game on the technical side, because I've never had a problem with it. But almost at this point, all of my friends have had some kind of technical issue with it. Nothing big, but definitely like a hiccup. Which is more than happened to me. Oh god, this boss, Maiku.
Yeah, I know. So, who's ready for an expletive-laden boss battle? Anybody? Anybody?
Raising my hand, I am. Looking forward to this, pulling up some popcorn. Be right back, Maiku, popping him some popcorn.
I bet you are. Up, and they got Torque. I've got you now. Goddamn Serpentine.
Hey, you didn't grab the... You didn't grab the shield, you silly willy. Oh, you already had one on. Never mind.
Yes.
Smart. Okay. I'm the dumb one in this. You're actually doing really, really good right out the gate, though.
Oh, and lost my shield.
Holy crap, you got to the second phase like that. You showed off why Mila is so freaking badass. You made that look like a cakewalk.
Oh. And Lilac comes in with the final blow.
Holy crap, Maiku, you thought that was gonna be hard. I thought that was gonna be hard. Holy shit, Mila really is the OP. That is so much harder as Lilac and Carol.
Oh.
Kind of. I've kind of learned how to cheese it with Carol, but you're not gonna be able to figure that out the first time through most of the time.
Maybe we're not cut out for this. We should go home.
Anyway, let's go ahead and to the next stage. And, I'm sorry, I got to disappoint, Nickafire because there were no expletives in that boss fight.
Amazing.
Oh, wow. Anyway.
You could have at least said a fuck yeah at the end. A bit, little bit of a fist pump.
No, I can't do it like that. Okay. Whatever. Anyway, fist bump the webcam. Alright.
I said pump, not bump.
Whatever. Well, I think Mikavar is providing his own expletives, so you can leave it at that. Anyway, Borch, thank you very much for joining me this stream.
Absolutely. It was a fun time.
And maybe we can get back to normal streaming at Wednesday nights at 9, maybe, possibly, kind of.
Probably.
Okay. Anyway, thanks Red Mage Mike and Mikafire for coming in and spending time with me, looking at me make a fool of myself and all that stuff. So, that's going to do it for me. Anyway, remember that there's somebody out there that cares about you no matter what. Until next time.
Later, everyone.